This video is brought to you by Restream.
Let's talk about how to manage comments on your live video. Hello and welcome to the channel. On this channel, we talk all about how you can use live video and videography to grow your business. And in this video, we're gonna talk about different ways you can go about to manage the comments on your live stream. Whether you're getting just a few comments, we're gonna talk everything from the very beginning of getting just a few comments and how to handle those, to if you're running big events and getting thousands of comments during your live streams. We'll cover all of that and everything in between. Let's dive in. And let's start out with the easy, simple way, if you're maybe just beginning to go live, how you can go ahead and manage comments. Maybe you're just going live from your phone directly. One of the best ways to go about managing the comments on there is just to pay attention to the comments that are happening on your screen as you're going live. Same can be said if you are going live directly from Facebook Live Producer or from YouTube, from their live streaming studio. You can manage the comments directly right there within that app, right on the screen as you're live. That's gonna be the simple and easiest way. And the spot where most people should be starting out is just getting used to managing comments and reading comments and questions through those in-app devices. But now maybe you're starting to step your game up just a little bit with your live streams, and either using like a webcam that might be a little further back or set up in a different way, or you're just getting used to having more and more comments come in, and you want to be sure to stay very engaged without having to like scroll through all the time to kind of check out those comments in a very awkward kind of way where you're reaching forward or scrolling through on the screen. That's where you could bring in that second device. And this could be used even again if you are using, say, your phone to live stream. You could have an iPad down on the desk in front of you or holding an iPad. Oftentimes that is what I'll do with clients, even as we get more advanced, is we'll give them some sort of iPad just to hang on to with their notes or with the comments pulled up at kind of that basic level where they can be reading through the comments this way. It's not very distracting, it's very natural, and honestly it looks pretty professional. So when you're ready to grab that second device, kind of that first step that you might want to do if you're only, say, going out to Facebook as the only way you're streaming, is to just to pull up the actual stream, and not necessarily from behind the scenes where you're actually going live or from like live producer, but to pull up what the public would be seeing, what people would be seeing, and just watch the comments that way. You wanna make sure that your device is all the way turned down so you're not getting any sort of sound or feedback from that, but you can just have the live stream going and you can monitor the comments that are coming in that way. Works really well when you're starting, you wanna take that professional level up just a little bit more. But all right, what if you're ready to maybe take your comment management up another step? You're ready to start, you know, adding things in like lower thirds or graphics or some sort of videos, but you're not ready to jump up to a full dedicated software. Maybe you're looking at a third-party in-browser type of experience. And this is where I would really recommend today's video sponsor, which is Restream. Restream has, what Restream is a software that allows you to multicast to several different streaming platforms, to YouTube, to Facebook, to LinkedIn, all at the same time. And I have a full video kind of walking you through a Restream tutorial. You can check that out by clicking the little icon up there. But what will happen here is in Restream Studio, that's kind of their basic browser switching software. Over on the side, you're gonna have a spot where all the chats are coming in, whether you're just going live to, say, even one Facebook page, all the chats for that will be coming in on the side there. And then you can click that little button, click a little device there, and bring those comments across the screen so that your viewers can see the comments that you're specifically addressing. So if someone asks a question, you can click that little question, click show, and it'll show up on your video and you can answer the question that way. This will also work with all the different platforms and bring them into one specific chat feed. And that makes it much easier for you because you're not gonna be having to switch back and forth to all the different feeds to try and manage that. Restream, in addition to Restream Studio, and then their normal multi-streaming service, is that they offer a specific chat function as well, which is going to allow, say, if you're not using Restream Studio and you're instead using another third-party switching software like ecamm or like vMix or just some other type of switching software out there, you can get everything, all the different platforms delivered into a single web browser or into a single application that's going to allow you to manage all of that with, again, not having to switch back and forth. And trust me, as someone who's done a lot of multicasting and multi-streaming, it can be a pain to try and manage comments when they're in several different locations. You're going to miss questions, you're going to miss comments. So having everything in that one tab is going to be extremely helpful. So that's why I recommend checking out Restream. If you want to learn more about Restream, again, I have the tutorial up here. Otherwise, you can head on over to nickpolkowski.com/Restream. And when you sign up using that link, you will get a $10 credit towards your Restream account. And I just really want to encourage you to go check it out because Restream is so powerful when it comes to comment management, which is what we're talking about here in this video. It not only does it have its web application, but it also has an actual downloadable Mac and PC application that you can use. And it's going to integrate comments from all kinds of different streaming platforms, whether that's YouTube, Facebook, LinkedIn, many others. It'll combine them all into that one single feed. And in addition to that, it even allows you to do command replies, which is something that I really encourage you, even if you're not using Restream, is to think about some maybe pre-written comments that you might want to deliver to some of your audience if they have questions about something specific. It's a great way, and with Restream, you're able to do that in just a couple keystrokes, which is awesome. And then one of my favorite things is the relay feature that it has. So that what that allows it to do is basically it's a bot that is going through and grabbing comments from, say, Facebook and putting them into the YouTube chat so that if you have somebody watching on YouTube, they're able to follow all of the threads across all of the different platforms that you're streaming on, which is incredibly powerful in making sure there's one conversation around your stream. Don't underestimate that. I think it's extremely powerful and extremely awesome. And of course, you're able to embed any of those comments right into your streaming video using Restream Chat. That's just like what we mentioned with Restream Studio, but with this function, you're able to do that with many other third-party switching software. So if you're using something like ecamm, OBS, or several others, you're able to actually embed the chat right in there thanks to Restream Chat, which is really awesome in creating a very engaging live streaming video. So if you're interested in at all learning more about Restream, go to nickpolkowski.com/Restream. And if you sign up using that link, you're gonna get a $10 credit on your Restream account. Plus you're gonna help support this channel. So thank you so much for doing that. And a huge thanks to Restream for sponsoring this video. But now I wanna talk about managing comments with a third party switching software. Now this, once you're ready to graduate to this level, this is where you're gonna be incorporating other types of elements, more things like lower thirds, and you want a more stable environment than what a browser-based switching software is going to give you. And these are gonna be a dedicated switching software like, say, ecamm for Macs. That's the one I recommend if you're interested in third-party software for Macs. But ecamm actually integrates specifically with the sponsor for this week, which is Restream, so that's really cool that they integrate with them. If you are going out to multiple different software services, multiple different platforms, ecamm is going to integrate with them and again bring everything together in that one feed. So I do really like ecamm as that third-party software allows you to bring comments across the screen as well, just like Restream does, like we mentioned before. And it's a really great kind of next step. And it's gonna, again, gonna allow you to manage comments, but bring them across screen, which is that extra little element that makes things a little more professional and allows your viewers to be even more engaged than they would if you were just reading the question without showing them. It helps build up that engagement level and people are more likely to wanna comment because they wanna see their comment go across screen. So it's a great way to help encourage those comments as well. Now, if you have a PC, I really recommend vMix. That's the switching software I definitely recommend. And again, we have links down in the description to that as well. But with vMix, it's kind of that high-end professional switching software, in my opinion. It's gonna allow you a lot more flexibility than ecamm or any of the other browser-based switching softwares. And it allows you to really dial things into the exact design and the exact template and the exact brand aesthetic that you want for your streams. And vMix has something called vMix Social, which again is going to incorporate multiple different streams if you're multi-streaming. So you could have a stream from Facebook, you could have a stream from YouTube. It doesn't allow you to do multiple different pages, which is the one downside compared to something like Restream. But it's going to bring all those together and allow you to push those across screen. It is also going to allow you to have that chat on any device that is connected to the network. So when I'm doing a higher end event where we might have a team of people kind of working with that live stream event, what we'll normally do is, especially if we expect lots of comments to come in, is I'll have a separate iPad and then I'll give that to one of the assistants for the day, somebody who's helping with the stream, and their entire job would be to manage comments and to what vMix allows you to do, vMix Social, is you can actually say somebody leaves a question, they can queue that up. They can enter it into a queue. So as the switcher, as the producer, I could just be monitoring the queue, or even as the presenter, you could just be monitoring the queue. And then when questions come in, they'll be in the queue and you can easily send those across screen. And then the presenter is gonna know exactly what they should be addressing and what they should be talking about. Before we get to the rest of the video, I just wanted to break in here and say that managing comments is just one of those elements that you need to consider for every live stream. I've actually put together an entire checklist of all the different elements you need to be considering when live streaming, and you can find that checklist by going to nickpolkowski.com/checklist. And now, back to the video. Now, we briefly mentioned having a team for a live event. There are several different options that you can do if you do happen to have another person working with you or even multiple different people working on this single live stream. The reason I love using some of these different options is because it's going to take a lot of the stress off the host or the presenter, so they don't have to be scrolling through every single comment that is coming in. Because what you want is a lot of people interacting in the chat. You want a lot of comments to be coming in, but as the person in front of the camera, it might be difficult to keep track of everything, to go through and find just the questions that are coming in or find the appropriate comments to go across. Especially, I know some of the streams that I've worked on, we've had, you know, millions of views. So this is gonna be very difficult if you're trying to handle a million view type. You're gonna have thousands of comments coming in. So you need to have some sort of system to manage that. And what I recommend is there's a couple different options depending on what your team is going to be familiar with and most comfortable with. Now, lately, because of the pandemic, been doing a lot of remote switching. So we've had people from all over beaming in to do a live stream together. And what I'll usually use for that is I'll use Zoom as the way to connect all the presenters, all the panelists or whatever together. And then I'll use vMix to be the actual switching software where it basically is just screen capturing the Zoom platform, or like either in gallery view or several different ways. I'll go into that in more detail in a future video. So be sure to subscribe if you want to see that video. But what we're able to do then is, say, have another team member who is just monitoring the comments. And then when a question happens, they can grab that question and paste it into the Zoom chat. So that way the MC, the person running who's on camera, only has to look at the Zoom chat for relevant comments or relevant questions that they should be addressing, and just helps streamline everything. Another way to do that would be, say, if your team is really familiar with Microsoft Teams. That's a great way to do that. Or if you're using Slack, all you have to do is set up, in either of those, all you have to do is set up a private channel for the people who are managing the comments and then the person who's presenting. So all the host has to do is, again, watch that channel for any appropriate comments. Another way I like to run that is to, say, give the presenter an iPad if we're doing something that is in person, but it's gonna be more in depth. It's gonna be a bigger stream, a bigger event, like a longer hour, hour and a half type of event, or just something that's going to have a lot of comments. I'll set up a Google Doc and we can have our person who is managing the comments can be anywhere in the world on that Google Doc. And all they are gonna do is they are gonna copy and paste in any questions or comments that they want the presenter to see. What this also allows us to do is, again, especially if it's a longer stream and we need to get some instructions to the host, we can easily make those red and make those bold so they stand out from everything else so the host can see that and know I'm not supposed to read any comments in red, and I'm just supposed to take action on those. Those are going to be instructions versus comments that they should be reading to the stream. And then when, say, the host asks the question, the people managing the comments, the team members managing the comments, can simply cross those off or just delete them entirely. And that way we have an easy ongoing document that is super easy to manage for the on-screen talent. Because that's ultimately what you want to do, is you want to make this as easy for the person in front of the camera to manage as possible so that they can focus on delivering great content and creating an engaging live stream video for those viewers. So hopefully that gives you tons of ideas of how to actually manage your comments from a live stream and from a live video, all the way from just getting started to those super high-end professional level streams where there's a full team dedicated to making this live stream or this event happen. There's multiple options in between. Pick the one that's going to work best for you and that's going to be most appropriate to where you are right now, and just get started. Let me know if you have any questions about managing comments. Leave a comment below just letting me know those questions. And also, if you're just getting started with live streaming, be sure to check out this playlist right here where I talk about how to get started with Facebook Live, or you can check out this video right here, which is the full tutorial on Restream if you're interested in using that software. Again, one of my favorites, highly recommend it. And be sure to hit subscribe so you don't miss a single video.